Hi kids, welcome back to GraviCalc, where each week we build a new digital logic circuit using GraviTrax marble runs. We're doing this to find out how computers and other electronics work on the inside. This is the sixth lesson in the series, and today is exciting because we're going to learn to count like a computer. If you haven't watched the previous lessons, you'll want to watch them first because they set the foundation for this lesson. In case you're new to my channel, I'm the Masked Marble, and my videos are all about things GraviTrax. Now, I don't wear a mask around my nose and mouth because marbles can't catch viruses. I just wear a mask around my eyes because it makes me look like a superhero. But I really don't have any superpowers, except the ability to roll really fast without getting dizzy. So you could say I have roly-poly power. In prior lessons, we learned about the seven simple digital logic gates and built tracks for each of them. This week, we will learn how computers count numbers. It's kind of the same as we count, but a little different. And we'll build a computer counting machine with a GraviTrax marble run. Let's start with a guessing game. We're going to see who can count higher using a single digit, you or a computer. Who do you guess can count higher? We'll start at one. Can you write a one as a single digit? Yep, well, so can a computer. So far, you and the computer are tied. Okay, how about two? Can you write two as a single digit? You can? Well, you just beat the computer, because a computer can't. What? Is this for real? Yep, a computer needs two digits to write the number two. It writes the number two as 10. Wait, that's 10, right? Not to a computer, it's not. To understand why not, first we'll run our GraviTrax counting machine and see how it counts. Then we'll take a closer look at how people count numbers in order to figure out how and why computers count differently. First, let's build a fun computer counting machine using GraviTrax. This machine will count the number of marbles that go through the track. Today's track only requires one GraviTrax starter set. Build it by loading the GraviTrax app code below into the free Ravensburger GraviTrax app, then switching to manual mode to get the build instructions. Today, we will build a small track that can count to three. Next week, if you have two starter sets, we will build a larger track that can count to 15. When you build your track, if you want, you can replace the launch pad with an angled green catcher insert. Then you can just drop each marble on the catcher instead of launching each marble from the launch pad. It's up to you. Now go ahead and pause the video and build the track. Do you remember from our previous lessons how a computer can only store a value of 0 or 1? And in our past GraviCalc tracks, we represented 1 with a marble and 0 with the absence of a marble. We're going to do something different today with today's GraviCalc track. We're going to use the switches to represent zeros and ones. Today, a switch pointing to the left represents a value of 0, and a switch pointing to the right represents a value of 1. To start with, all our switches should be pointing to the left, which means we start our count at 0. As we count, we are going to release one marble at a time in the track, and the switches will change positions to tell us the total. As we count, we're going to leave all the marbles that have completed the track in the landing pad. Then we can easily count the total number of marbles in the landing pad at any time and check the position of the switches to see how a computer represents that number of marbles. Now let's pretend we are a computer. Beep, 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 boop. And we need to count to 3. We start counting at 1, so go ahead and run a marble through your track. What happened? You can see that the rightmost switch moved from 0, pointing left, to 1, pointing right. So far, a computer counts to 1 the same way we do. Leave the first marble in the landing pad and run a second marble through the track. What happened there? The rightmost switch moved back to zero, pointing left, and the next switch to the left moved to one, pointing right. So the first two switches together now read 1, 0. That's weird. Doesn't 1, 0 mean 10? But we've only counted two marbles so far. Does a computer think that 10 means 2? Now run a third marble through your track. What happened to the switches? Now they read 1, 1. Isn't that 11? But we have three marbles in our landing pad. We've counted to 3, but a computer is saying that's 11. Actually, to a computer, 1, 1 is not 11, but 3. Okay, so what is this strange way of counting? Why doesn't a computer count like we do? Actually, a computer does count like we do, but it can't count as high as we do using a single digit. To understand what's going on here, we first need to take a closer look at how people count numbers. Our system of numbers is based on counting in groups of 10 because we have 10 fingers on which to count. And when we write down the numbers we are counting, we start by writing single digits in the ones place value. We write 1, or 2, or 3, or 6. When we write an 8 in the ones place, that means we have 8 ones, which is 8 total things we are counting. When we write a 9 in the ones place, that means we have 9 ones, which is 9 total. But once we count to 10, we do something different. We don't have a single digit anymore to represent 10. 10 won't fit in the ones place. To write 10, we write it as a 1 followed by a 0. That's 2 digits. We write the 1 in the tens place and a 0 in the ones place. And that means we have 1 10 plus 0 ones, or 10 total things we are counting. Next, when we write 11, we write a 1 in the tens place and a 1 in the ones place, which stands for 1 10 plus 1 1 or 11. When we write 12, we write a 1 in the tens place and a 2 in the ones place, and that stands for 1 10 plus 2 ones, or 12. And we keep following this pattern as we continue counting. We just saw that the biggest number that fits in the ones place when we count is a 9. When we write 9, it fits in the ones place, but once we count to 10, it doesn't fit, so we have to write a 1 in the tens place, and then reset the ones place back to 0. So we write a 10 as a 1, 0. So here's a question for you. What is the biggest number we can fit in both the tens place and the ones place put together? Can we fit the number 34 in the tens and ones places? Yes. We write 3 in the tens place and 4 in the ones place. And that stands for 3 tens plus 4 ones, or 34. Can we fit the number 89 in the tens and ones places? Yep, we write 8 in the tens place and 9 in the ones place, which stands for 8 tens plus 9 ones, or 89. Can we write 264 in the tens and ones places? No, we write 264 by putting 2 in the hundreds place, 6 in the tens place and 4 in the ones place. That means we have 2 hundreds plus 6 tens plus 4 ones. Have you guessed what is the biggest number that will fit in both the tens and ones places? It's 99. When we write 9 in the tens place and 9 in the ones place, both place values are full. And if we add one more to the number, to 99, we reach 100. Then we put a 1 in the hundreds place and reset both the tens place and the ones place to 0. So this is how people count. No matter how high we count, we keep following this pattern. For example, if we have 999 and add one more, it becomes 1,000, with a 1 in the thousandths place and all the lower place values reset to 0. We call our number system a base 10 number system because it is based on this repeating pattern of 10. In our base 10 number system, each place value is 10 times the previous place value. We call that multiples of 10. So the first place value is 1s. The next place value is 10 times 1, or 10. The next place value is 10 times 10, which is 100. The next place value is 10 times 100, which is 1,000. The next place value is 10 times 1,000, which is 10,000. The next place value is 10 times 10,000, which is 100,000. The next place value is 10 times 100,000, which is 1 million. And it keeps going and going. Each place value is 10 times the previous place value. But how do computers count? Why don't they count the way we do? Well, the problem is computers don't have 10 fingers to count on. Remember, computers can only count using ones and zeros. This means that after they count to 1, in order to count to 2, they have to move to the next place value, just like we do in order to count to 10. Since a computer's number system is based on 2 instead of 10, we call it a base 2 number system. It is based on multiples of 2. The base 2 number system is also called the binary number system. So let's reset our track and run it again and see if we can figure out what's going on with computer counting. Reset all your track switches to the left so they all read as zeros, and remove any marbles that are in the landing pad. As we run our track this time, remember these switches are going to show us the total count in the base 2 number system that computers use, not the base 10 system that people use. So when we read the numbers, we'll need to convert them from base 2 numbers to base 10 numbers in order to understand them. But it's super easy to do this, and I'll show you how as we continue. Before we start counting, I want you to notice that in your track there is a 1 above the rightmost switch, made out of white GraviTrax tiles. That is to remind us that this switch represents the 1's place in the computer. Let's start counting. We start counting at 1. Go ahead and run the first marble through your track. What happened? The 1's place switch was reading 0, but now it reads 1. Now that the 1's place switch is pointing to the right, this means we have a 1 in the 1's place, which is a total count of 1 marble. So far, a computer is counting just like we count, by showing the digit 1 in the 1's place. When counting up to 1, both the base 2 and base 10 number systems count the same. They both represent the number 1 by showing a 1 in the 1's place. Pretty easy, right? This is baby stuff so far. But now, let's get to the fun part. Remember to leave the first marble in the landing pad, alright? Now we're going to count to 2. But a computer does not know what a 2 is. It can only count using 1s and 0s, so it cannot put a 2 in the 1's place like we do when counting in the base 10 number system. Since there is already a 1 in the 1's place, a computer's 1's place is full. So what's going to happen? Go ahead and run the second marble through your GraviTrax counting computer. What happened? Now there are 2 marbles in the landing pad, meaning we have counted 2 marbles. But you will see that the second switch is now pointing to the right, which represents a 1, and the 1's place switch has been reset to the left, which represents a 0. Here's what is happening. To count higher than 1, a computer has to use the next place value. Just like in our base 10 system of counting, when we write a 10 by putting a 1 in the 10's place and resetting the 1's place to 0, to write a 2 in the base 2 system, a computer has to put a 1 in the second place value, and reset the ones place value to 0, resulting in two digits that read 10. But here's the catch. In a computer, the second place value is not the tens place. It's actually the twos place. That's why there is a number 2 above the second switch in our track made out of GraviTrax tiles. That will remind us that the second switch is not the tens place, but the twos place. We're counting in binary computer numbers, not in base 10 people numbers. When a computer counts to 2, it writes it as 10, which actually means 12 plus 0 ones. Now this might seem a little confusing because a 10 looks like a 10 to us. And in our base 10 number system, a 10 is a 10. But remember, we're writing this number in a base 2 number system, and in that system, a 10 means 2, because that second place value stands for the number of 2s, not the number of 10s. 10 to a computer means you have a 2 and no 1s, and 2 plus 0 equals 2. Our GraviTrax counting computer switches are displaying a 1 in the 2's place and a 0 in the 1's place, which means 12 plus 0 1's, which is 2. It's actually the same method we use to count, but using digits that carry over to the next place value when they reach 2, not 10. Okay, what happens when a computer counts from 2 to 3? Well, we are starting with 2, which means we have a 1 in the 2's place and a 0 in the 1's place. Go ahead and run a third marble through your GraviTrax counting computer. Now we have 3 marbles in the landing pad showing that we have counted 3 marbles. What do the switches show now? We have a 1 in the 2's place and a 1 in the 1's place, which means 12 plus 11, or that is 2 plus 1 or 3. And so a computer writes a 3 as 11. In our base 10 system, we would read 11 as 11. But in a computer's base 2 system, a 11 is read as 3. If this is still confusing, don't worry. Reset your GraviTrax computer counting machine and run the marbles through a few more times and think about what's happening. See if you can figure out the pattern. And run a fourth marble through the track and see what happens. Next week, when we count to 15, it should be a lot clearer because then our counting computer will have 4 switches instead of 2. When you see how they all work together, the binary counting system that computers use should be crystal clear. In the meantime, have fun playing around with your GraviTrax computer counting machine. Parents, if you have one GraviTrax starter set and were thinking about getting a second one, this would be a great time to do so. Next week's track is a lot of fun, but requires 2 starter sets. If you don't want to purchase a second starter set, you can still follow along with next week's video. If you do purchase a second starter set and you don't have any of the GraviTrax Vertical Pro parts, you might consider adding a Vertical Pro starter set to your collection, which retails for $80 US but can sometimes be found online for less. The Vertical Pro starter set contains a lot of unique parts to build GraviTrax layouts higher. Although you can get most of these unique parts in the $25 Vertical Pro expansion set. The best bang for your buck on a second starter set might be the obstacle set, which resellers are selling on eBay for $50 to $60 new. The obstacle set contains the basic starter set bundled with $65 worth of expansions, trampolines, bridges, spirals, transfers, and a zipline. Or the cheapest route might be to purchase a second basic starter set, which is now selling online for about $39, a much better deal than the original retail price. Okay, see you next week.